Welcome. In this video, we will learn about macros. First of all, we will understand that what is a macro. A macro is an action or a set of actions that you can run as many times as you want. While creating a macro, we record mouse clicks and keystrokes. These are the advantages of macros. The first one is it reduces human error, it saves time and makes complex tasks easier. We will come back to advantages once again. Let us first of all run a macro and understand that what macro can do. This is an example where we have student names and the score in various subjects and we want to calculate total and percentage. What I have done is, I have already recorded a macro and stored it. So, whenever I need to calculate it once again, I need not to type the formulas or do the calculations manually. So, what I need to do is, I just need to go to Tools, Macros and then Run Macros. And from there, I will choose the place where I have stored my macro. So, my macro name is Calculate Student Marks. And when I run it, it will automatically do all the work which I have already stored. Now I will come back to advantages of macros. The first one is it reduces human error. So when I stored this macro, I have already checked that whether the calculations are correct or incorrect or whatever I have done, is that correct. So whenever I rerun it, there is no chance of error. Second thing is it saves time. Obviously, you must have seen that when I clicked on run, it immediately did all the work which I wanted to do. So that is how it saves a lot of time. Make complex tasks easier. Obviously, many a times you do some complex tasks and if you store that task in a macro, then you just need to run the macro and it will do the complex task easily. Furthermore, there are other advantages also. For example, a Hindi or English teacher who don't know how to do the calculations, what can be done is a computer teacher can create this macro and then they just need to run it. This is how it will be easier for them to operate the computer and do the calculations easily. Now we will understand how these macros are organized in OpenOffice. The first thing is there is a library container. Then in that library container we have library. In that library we have module and a module contains macros. Here my macros, OpenOffice macros and untitled one are library containers and standard and test, they are libraries. Test macro and module one are modules and some underscore numbers and hello underscore world are macros in test macro module. So now I will explain you that how you can record your own macro. Recording macro is a very easy process. What you need to do is you have to go to Tools and from there you choose Macros and then Record Macros. Now whatever you will do in your OpenOffice will be recorded. So I write over here sum and then I do this for the summation and then for percentage I write this formula. Now if I think that I have done, so I can click on stop. Immediately I will get this dialog box to save my macro. So here we have my macros, we have OpenOffice macros and untitled 2. This untitled 2 means the current document. Now, if I save my macros in my macros, it will be available in all the OpenOffice Calc documents. But if I save this in this file, it will be available only in this particular file. Let us save this in untitled. I just need to click on here, then standard library. If I wanted to create a new library, I can also do that. I just need to click over here and say my and OK. Another library is created over here, and we have standard library also. That totally depends upon you whether you want to create a new library or not. So I just go to my, and then in the module I just name it create score and click save. Now if I don't have this data over here, then I can go to tools, macros, run macros, untitled, my module 1 and create score. I just run it and it will give me this value. So this is how we can record and store our macros. Now if I don't store this file and close and say discard, and when I open my OpenOffice Calc once again, there is no such file, and even my macro is not there. The new macro which I have created is not there, because that macro was associated with the OpenOffice Calc file. But if I have stored that macro is in my macros, it will be available to all the Calc sheets. So this is how we can record a macro and store it. Thanks for now. See you in the next video.